Okay, let's take a look at the SMB Beacon. For this demo, we're going to work from my local host team server. And you can see I've taken this Whatahog beacon and set it to beacon back every 5 seconds. Okay? So now we've got a beacon to work through. Let's go ahead and create a SMB beacon listener. Let's go to these little headphones and let's press add and create Windows Beacon SMB. We'll call it Beacon SMB. And let's give this value here, which will go into the pipe name, and press save. And there we go. We now have an SMB beacon listener. The SMB beacon listener is really useful for things like privilege escalation and lateral movement. And we'll see both of those later in this course. But for now, let me show you what I mean by that. I'm going to use an attack called bypass UAC, which we'll explain later when we talk about privilege escalation. And I'm going to target the Beacon SMB listener with this particular attack. Okay? Basically, what this attack is going to do is give me a new beacon that is running with elevated writes in certain situations. And what you can see is we get a new beacon that is linked through this parent beacon. Okay? So this beacon, Whatahog, is Whatahog star. The star means administrator level rights. The chain here means it's linked through the address referenced here, okay? And if you see red with lightning bolts in the session views, that means an elevated context. Cool. Now, why don't we inject an SMB beacon into a system process? Let's go pull a process list real quick. And let's find something running a system that looks kind of cool. Why not VMToolsD? So we'll inject into this system level process and we'll inject an SMB beacon, okay? This is another action or another example of targeting a local host process or localhost only action with the SMB beacon. So now we have another beacon that's chained through this beacon, which is egressing through this beacon. So now we're kind of pivoting or chaining two levels deep on the same system. Okay. Now it can get really confusing when you're moving around a system or even a network by chaining multiple levels deep. It can be really hard to keep track of those chains in this view. This is why we have the pivot graph. If we come over here to show sessions and pivot graph, you can see that Cobalt Strike will visualize the SMB beacon chain for us. Now it's a lot clearer. Here we see our initial foothold. We see our initial privilege escalation, so the beacon that gets us into an elevated context. And we see the beacon that we injected into a system level process. Pretty cool, right? So that's an example of visualizing the beacon chain. Now I mentioned before that you can also use the SMB beacon to control systems host to host. Let me show you what that looks like. Let's come over here and interact. And we're going to take a system that I happen to know I am an administrator on, and that system's called Granite. And we're going to talk more about PSExec PowerShell and friends in the lateral movement lecture. But let's just do PSExec PowerShell, Granite, local beacon SMB. And this is going to stage a SMB beacon over a name pipe. And there we go. We now have control of this other system, and it's chained through this one. Okay? Cool. Now, let's say I don't want to control this system anymore. Well, we can de-link this SMB beacon. Let me show you how. We just do unlink and give it the address of the beacon we want to unlink. So this is the IP address of Granite. And there you can see it's disconnected. Okay, cool. Later, you can use the link command to assume control of an SMB beacon from elsewhere. So here we're going to link to Granite. Okay. So this beacon is going to try to assume control of Granite. And there you can see our pivot graph reflecting the new communication path for this beacon. So the SMB beacon is a very flexible tool to let you pivot process to process on the same host or pivot host to host by chaining beacons together.